MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game one of the American League Division Series between the Minnesota Twins and the Houston Astros. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Zach Greinke will do the pitching in front of a hometown crowd here in game one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Zach Greinke, one of the most complete pitchers in the game of baseball. Four pitch mix. I don't think anybody commands the fastball as well as Zach Greinke. Up, down, in and out, he can dot the fastball. Good curveball, good change. Has the slider that he'll throw to both righties and lefties. If Zach Greinke brings his A game, he can shut anybody down.
So now into the box is Max Kepler, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Fouled away. Our game one thermostat, about what you'd expect for October, 55 degrees at first pitch. The 2-2. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Boy, it's so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player. Fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Into the box now, Luis Arraez. And he fouls this one off. Greinke comes set. 1-2 on its way. A little bouncer. Kepler on at first. Nobody out. Struck him out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
To the plate now, Josh Donaldson. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. In the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, when you throw a breaking ball in the dirt, that's the danger. You have to trust your catcher, but this one skips away, and the open base takes the double opportunity away with it. Might prove to be costly.
Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
You would think in this situation, maybe with a base open, he'd just pitch around him and put him on first. But not with the guy in the on-deck circle. He's going to attack this hitter.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Classic slider down and away for the strike out there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch. It hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Into the box, Nelson Cruz. The ballman, two strikes.
These are the moments right here. You got a good pitcher on the mound. You don't know if these opportunities are going to present themselves throughout the course of the game. You have to capitalize in this situation.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Twins wind up stranding one. Now the Astros will get their first opportunity. No score. Kenta Maeda gets the call in hostile territory here for game one of the division series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
Here comes the second baseman, Jose Altuve, to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one. And one pitch. And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Third baseman, Alex.
At the plate now is Alex Bregman. A runner at first with no outs here. Good slider there, but laid off and called the ball low.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
Set to deliver on 2-1. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And hey, a strikeout always works too.
Throw over to first. A dive, but he's back in there. In now, Michael Brantley. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however. The second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. They'll move on to the second now at Truist Park with no score. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. Greinke looks in. Here's the 3-1. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Now the 3-2 pitch. He's at the knees and called strike three.
Boy, he's really on a roll on the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
Stepping in now, Kyle Garlick. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. One out, nobody on. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Wow, that's four straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number five right here. You can tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
Now the 3-2 pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him. And with two away now, let's give you a look at the big picture here. There you see the participants in this year's playoffs. That'll bring in Byron Buxton. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. No score here as we play inning number two. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and no one will get this one. Goodness, how about this? He struck out the side in back-to-back innings. Six in a row, and the inning is over. Twins are set down 1-2-3. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Half of the second set to go, and ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. Three-two pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
So now to the plate, Yordan Alvarez. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
Every pitcher looks to get off to a good start, and I'd say he's off to a good start. How about the first five batters he's faced? Three of them he sent down via the strikeout.
Into the box now, Yuli Gurriel. And the count will be full.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Astros. We'll move to the third with no score. Now to bat, Ryan Jeffers. He'll lead it off against Zach Greinke to open up the inning. There's the 2-1 home. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Tucker is over a few steps toward the line, and he has it for the first out. So one away now in the Minnesota third. And standing in, one of the best two-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
This one's blooped out toward right center field. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Well, that's a nice base hit right there. Way to break up the rhythm. That was almost eight in a row. This guy was starting to get his bearings about him on the mound. Had to break it up.
To the plate now, Max Kepler. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now. Fast fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch.
Count remains 2-2.
When the guy on the mound has complete command of his off speed, especially his changeup, sometimes as a hitter, you just have to give up pull side to stay on it.
Fouled off. Simmons stands at first with one out. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Strong is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Two down with a runner at first, and next to hit will be Luis Arraez. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Count remains full. Another full count pitch home. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Josh Donaldson digging in now. Struck out in his first at bat.
This guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Can't keep that one fair, and now the count's full. Line drive to left. Coming on is Brantley, but he won't get there. It's a base hit. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0. The tag, and they'll get him at second, and with that, the side is retired. Twins get a run on two hits. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Twins 1 and the Astros 0. Into the box, Kyle Tucker. To 2-2 now.
This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making contact, let alone putting the ball in play.
Chin-high slider laid off for a ball.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
Liner toward right center. And there's the first hit of the game for Houston.
Boy, just when you like to get one of those shut down innings, the leadoff guy ends up reaching base right now, and you're looking for that 1-2 inning. Now you have to pitch out of the stretch.
Yeah, I can't tell you how that lights up an offensive dugout right there, getting that leadoff guy on. So many options, puts the pitcher on the defensive and in the stretch.
At the plate, Miles Strong. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Hit hard towards center. In there, a base hit.
Dan, he took that right back in his face right there. Exactly what you're trying to do. Middle cut, though. Are you a little concerned?
Yeah, that's a face of a ball being right down the middle. As a pitcher, you want to work the corners and stay out of that middle part of the zone. And he paid for it right there with a solid base hit.
Stepping in now, Jason Castro. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Bounced softly in front of the plate. And he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now.
Now back.
Striding in is Jose Altuve trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Strike two, and now it's full 3-2.
misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
I'm sure the manager is fine with that. He tried to entice him with that 3-2 pitch, but he didn't take the bait. First base was open, though, so he just needs to make a good pitch for a ground ball.
Now at the plate here is Alex Bregman, a potential tying run for him at third base. Here comes the 1-2. Tucker on third, Straw on second, Altuve the first, one gone. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. A drive into the gap in right center as he comes through with extra bases. One run is scored. It's cut off, so all three runners are in to score.
Bases loaded, and he was looking to drive them all in the second he stepped into the box. Puts a big swing on this thing, and the ball just gets down to the wall, allowing everyone to come around and score. He'll take a three-run double every day of the week.
At the plate now, Michael Brantley, skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and hit for third. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. Here's Carlos Correa now, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. One and two now as that's in there at the knees.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late. And you can't even put a good swing on it.
Three runs already home here. To two balls and two strikes now.
He certainly has an open base down there, but you don't want your defender standing flat-footed for much longer.
Curveball that's laid off that time. It's full 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
But McCarty on that swing as it's well wide of first. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Still three balls and two strikes. The eighth pitch of the at-bat. And a swing and a miss here. So it took him 31 pitches, but the side is finally retired. So three runs on three hits, no errors, and a man left. On to the fourth now in game number one. It's the Astros 3 and the Twins 1. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Here's Nelson Cruz now. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
You know, these next couple innings are really important for these guys. I know they're only down by a couple, but they need to get something going on offense to keep pace, even though it's early.
3-1 to him now. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH.
Okay.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
In now, Miguel Sano. A two-ball, one-strike count to the Twins' first baseman.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. The count now at 2-2.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Up next, Kyle Garlick struck out in his first at bat. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And he is safe at second base as the decision to move up pays off, and that'll likely be scored a wild pitch.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up free bases.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
To the plate now, Byron Buxton. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. And another foul ball. Cruz stands at second with two gone. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. One left for Minnesota, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've been able to push across 3 runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. Cold strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. And that one yanked just foul. Now another 1-2. And the shift will not amount to much here as this is lifted in the air out to right field. Kepler is over near the stands as he makes the catch for the first down. No one on with one down. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. 3-1 is our score here in inning number 4. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. And there are 2 away now. So 2 out, nobody on. And in to hit next will be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. 3 runs, 3 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Chopper foul. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Buxton will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3 as the lead remains 3-1. And now here is Ryan Jeffers, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. This one's flared out toward left. Here comes Brantley, but he won't get there. It falls in. Into the box now, Andrelton Simmons. A ball and two strikes to the Twins shortstop. Now some action out in the Houston bullpen as it appears both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. 3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. And this is popped up near second base. Altuve waits on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting the right fielder.
So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2.
Take a step back right here. After 3 fastballs in a row, there is no chance he throws you a 4th.
Looking for his 10th strikeout. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far.
That's 10 strikeouts for him now. And I'll tell you, he could rack up quite a few more before he's done. Still a lot of game left in this one.
Standing in now, Luis Arraez. Line to the right side. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Jeffers is off of first with 2 away. In the dirt, and now let's see. The tag, and he is safe on a very close play at the bag. Drilled to the right side. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And a good effort here, but he's well safe at first, and there are 2 on and 2 out now. At the plate, Josh Donaldson. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
And I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down the way, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that.
Now, meanwhile, this ball's going to get through, and that's a base hit. And the runner from third scores as they try and work their way back into this one. It's now a 3-2 contest.
Hey, there's a good job of battling right there, D-Row. Pitcher have the advantage with 2 outs, 2 strikes. You're 1 pitch away, and boy, what a terrific piece of hitting right there.
Yeah, that's a great job right there. Some guys are not afraid to hit with 2 strikes. They'll take that pitcher deep in the count, feeling comfortable about it. That's the type of hitter this guy is, and he was able to come through.
Drive by Cruz. Deep left field. Leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. A 3-run shot down the line in left, and it's now 5-3.
It looked like he might just work out of that inning, only giving up a single run. But it all comes crashing down on that mistake. Nothing like a 3-run bomb to change the entire complexion of your day on the mound.
So now to the plate, Miguel Sano. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike 2. 4 runs here in this half inning. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Back up the middle. That's through, and he's got his first base hit. He's 1-for-3. As we take a look at his numbers, a couple of things jump out at you.
Definitely, Matt. He's been throwing it by guys the entire game, but that leads to some high pitch counts, and that's the case here. After that hit, you have to wonder if he's starting to get a little bit fatigued.
Yeah, and in today's game, everyone seems to want to err on the side of caution in terms of pitch counts. Now here comes the Houston manager out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a change here, as that's going to be all tonight for Zach Greinke. So he'll depart here in the fifth after working just four and two thirds, and he's on the hook for the L unless this one turns around. Ryan Stanek takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. At the plate now, Kyle Garlick. And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes.
He's staring a hat trick in the face right now after that swing. He has just got to find a way to zone up a little bit more. You cannot expect to make solid contact chasing stuff outside the zone.
Swing and a ground ball to third. Throw on to first will finally retire him as the inning will draw to a close. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a three-run home run. Middle of the night here at Truist Park. It's now 5-3 Twins. So now here is Miles Straw. He collected a base hit his first time up. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. To 2-2 now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
And he pops him up, drifting toward the left side of the infield. There to look it in is Simmons, one away.
The catcher.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Bases are empty, one man out. And here's one that misses to the Houston catcher. It's 2-1 now.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. If you can hit the outside corner of that pitch, it's unhittable.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Bouncer to the left side. Donaldson's there. Throw on to first and get him. Score it 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Jose Altuve. Down the first baseline. And the throw will be too late as he can't recover in time. Here's a look over to first, and he'll dive back in. Stepping in now, Alex Bregman, skied into straightaway right. Kepler's on his horse. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Astros leave one. Still a two-run deficit. It's 5-3. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Brantley is under it. One down. Next to dig in, Ryan Jeffers. He's one for two in this one. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted high and deep. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. So a solo shot here to left center field, and it's now 6-3.
Yeah, and you never want to downplay a home run, but they've had runners on base all game long and couldn't get a home run in that situation. Hey, it's only a solo shot, but they'll take it. But you have to think they're feeling like they've missed some opportunities in this one.
In now, Andrelton Simmons. Two balls and a strike to count to Andrelton Simmons. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Six runs, nine hits, and no errors in the ball game for Minnesota. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2.
Hey guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight, where it's super cold out, if you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
And a good effort on the dive that time, but this will get by him for a base hit.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
To the plate now, Max Kepler. And he's keeping it down here, and that's a cold strike two. The 1-2 gets him looking up around the letters.
Runner on first in a double play situation, so you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone. So I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
Standing in now, Luis Arraez, swing and a line drive, and that's in there, base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Now batting, third baseman, John Jones.
So now to the plate, Josh Donaldson. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And a leaping effort at the wall, but it's in vain, a home run. So a three-run shot to left center as it's now a six-run ball game.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Brooks Raley, a southpaw, standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. Now, Nelson Cruz.
That's a ball.
Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. Now a half swing here on the pitch inside, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the home plate umpire. Strike two. Here now the 2-2. Is laid off and the count runs full. Two out, nobody on. Lifted in the air out towards left center.
Strong
there to put it away and finally put an end to the inning. So four runs in the inning, and they come on the strength of the two big flies. Heart of the order, 3, 4, and 5 coming up. Twins lead it 9-3. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Hit down the line at first. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Now here it comes. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And he makes the throw to first. Brantley is retired, and there's one away.
The batter, number one.
So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa.
Correa.
The 1-2 pitch.
Still a ball and two strikes.
Here's another 1-2.
Got him!
And he goes down on strikes for the third time. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Into the box, Yordan Alvarez. 3-2 now. Thing has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on and driven to right, and no doubt about it. And this one is gone. A home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field as they try to claw back. It's a 5-run deficit.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
At the plate, Yuli Gurriel. Gurriel behind, a ball and two strikes. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a little tapper. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes. Yank the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Just hung in there on that one. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
Popped up. Simmons is under it. And he's got it for the final out of the frame.
Astros get a run back here on the solo shot. The 5, 6, and 7 hitters to start the 7th. It's now 9-4. So now to the plate, Miguel Sano. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Fouled away. One and two. Here it comes. Hit sharply on the ground. Altuve has it. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Next, it'll be Kyle Garlick, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Here's a ground ball out to the shortstop, Correa. Throw gets him, 2 down. Next up is Byron Buxton. He flew out in his last AB. 2 out, nobody on. Ball and 2 strikes now. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. There is Altuve. Onto the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Down go the Twins in order. They're on top, however, 9-4. Cody Stashak will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the 7th.
Minnesota, number 61, Cody.
Last half of the 7th here, and next it'll be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. The 1-1 home.
Hey! 1 ball, 2 strikes to count.
Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. A full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Miles Straw is on deck. He's set, and the payoff pitch. And he fouls this one off. Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. A solo shot down the line in right as they've cut this deficit down to 4.
Pitch, he couldn't get around on a fastball and was mad at himself. Well, there's nothing to be mad about anymore unless you're the guy standing on the mound wondering what just happened.
To the plate now, Miles Straw. There's a fastball on the inner third taken for a strike. Little chopper back to the mound. And a good throw gets him, 1 gone. Now into the box, Jason Castro. One run in and 1 gone so far this inning.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Looked to me like he had the right idea with the swing on that pitch, and he just didn't get the bat through the zone in time. The pitch was away. He let it get deep, maybe trying to take it the other way, but it got too deep and was by him by the time his barrel could get in the correct position.
In now, Jose Altuve. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
Full count. 3-2.
Pops this one up. Sano is there for it, and that will end the inning. Astros get a run here courtesy of the solo homer. 7 complete here tonight. It's now 9-5. Joe Smith has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 38, Joe
Smith. Now at the plate is Ryan Jeffers. It was a solo shot for him in his last at bat. The 1-1 home. Is swung on and missed for strike number 2. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
You know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
And he popped him up back into foul territory behind first. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Ready with another 2-2. High and deep down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
High in the air out towards shallow right. Tucker has to come in a few steps, but he has it for route number 1. Next to hit, Andrelton Simmons singled in his last at bat. Lifts it into the air to shallow Correa, trying to get there, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range, heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Stepping in now, Max Kepler. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip it on to first, and with it, that ends the inning. Twins are set down 1-2-3 as they can't add to their 9-5 lead. Hansel Robles is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 57, Hansel Robles.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman. Yeah. lifted in the air out towards left center.
Bryant
is under this one, and he's got it for out number one. So stepping in is Michael Brantley. His career numbers against this pitcher. He's a perfect 3-for-3. He's taken him deep once. Here comes the payoff pitch. Down the left field line and deep. But this will wind up being a foul ball. High fly ball out to deep right field. Kepler looks up. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. And just like that, it's down to a three-run ball game. Here's the pitch.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Fouled off. Another payoff pitch. There's ball four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Now picking for the plane. So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. Jordan Alvarez will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. He called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
Into the box, Yuli Gurriel.
Count it three,
and he misses again, ball three.
Well, tying run on deck, he should get something really good to hit right here in a 3-1 count. I'd be sitting on a fastball middle in.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
The right fielder, number 30.
Next to stand in is Kyle Tucker. Last go to solo homer last time up. Swing as he pulls this one into right. Kepler gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. But not before they answer back here with a solo home run. On to the ninth inning from Truist Park. It's the Twins 9 and the Astros 6. Steve Cishek enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth.
Cishek.
All set to start the ninth in this one, and set to go is the second baseman, Luis Arraez. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is a fastball that misses. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
You know, from a hitter's perspective, you get pounded in, and then he throws a nasty changeup away. Is the mindset to tell yourself that he's going to go in and out all day long, or is he going to double up? That's the cat and mouse we're seeing right now.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
And it's fouled away. Another full count pitch home. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch. Might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
Josh Donaldson will stand in again as we flash you back here to inning number six. This three-run home run that's really been the key blow to this point in the ballgame. Aboard here at first with nobody out. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
That ugly. You'd probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the rosin bag if you throw it up there.
Here comes the 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Another one sent foul. Cishek's ready. Looking to put him away here on a ball and two strikes. Altuve for one to Gurriel, and they get them both.
Made him throw a lot of pitches in that at bat, but he'll take the double play as a trade-off for sure.
Nelson Cruz will stand in as he's accounted for one of the biggest at-bats of the game so far. A three-run shot back in the fifth that's really energized his ball club. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll be off the wall in right center. The relay, and he's able to hustle his way up the second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Now back,
Well, when you're hitting the ball as well as he is, every time you swing the bat, you're thinking the ball's leaving the ballpark. He had a home run last time, and he almost had another one here. Nothing wrong with a double off the wall, though.
Standing in now, Miguel Sano. And that misses 2-1. Hard hit toward the hole. And that's through into left, a base hit. Cruz rounds third and is digging for the plate. The tag, and he's in there. And they lead now by 4. To the plate now, Kyle Garlick, fouled away. The 1-2 is taken for ball two. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Runner in scoring position at second with 2 down. Bouncer up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And he'll reach first safely. Blake Taylor takes over now with 2 gone here in the top of inning number 9.
Number 62. Blake.
Into the box now, Byron Buxton. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. Twins forced to settle for 1. We'll see 8, 9, and 1 due up in the bottom of inning number 9. It's the Twins 10 and the Astros 6. Tyler Duffy, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. The 1-1.
We got 2 balls.
Some movement now in the Minnesota bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Now the 2-1. Doesn't hit the target. It's ball 3.
It's been a great job so far by the 8-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. The 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed, strike 3.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's now just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Death throw.
In now, Jason Castro. And he fouls this one off. Bases are empty, 1 man out. Count still at 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And he strikes him out as well. So 2 punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen now to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
So now to the plate, Jose Altuve. Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. This ball's in the air to left field, and this should do it. And that is going to wrap things up as the catch is made, and the Twins have taken home field advantage right from the start. They claim game one on the road as this one is over.
Wow, plenty of runs to go around in this one. Not a great day to be a pitcher, that's for sure. These hitters look like they knew it was coming as soon as the ball was coming out of the hand. A wild game indeed.
Six, the final score in this game. The Twins win the opener here in the division series. Kenta Maeda is the winning pitcher of record. Zach Greinke struck out 10 in the losing effort. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Twins, 10 runs, 15 hits, no errors, they left 7 men on base. For the Astros, 6 runs, 7 hits, no errors, they left 5 men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 9 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Truist Park, 41,500. The Braves thank you for your continued support and remind you to please drive home safely.